was not taking proper care of the people who were in training. Humane agents were called to the premises where they found horrific living conditions. 15 dogs, including a dog named Nitro, although this legislation today, were discovered dead or dying. The remaining animals were suffering from starvation, dehydration, and dropped the kennel by his owner. Nitro was a healthy 105-pound Rottweiler. He was found dead and weighed 45 pounds. He died curled up in a fetal position with his bones protruding from his body, with his nails split open and flying to the in the cage. The owner was taken into custody, and 19 pounds of cruelty to animals were originally charged, which were reduced to 4 counts. At the time, that Ohio only provides a misdemeanor penalty for animal cruelty, regardless of the brutality. The two royal camel owners have been getting away with slaps on the wrist when they look at pain like this with pets under their care. This field-based animal abuse by a camel owner, 5th degree felony. House Bill 108 gives local prosecutors the authority to charge the owner, custodian, or caretaker. You are a licensed kennel owner in the state of Ohio. You're caring for companion animals, and you knowingly, you have to knowingly do this, torture, torment, needlessly mutilate or maim, cruelly beat, poison, recklessly kill, any of these acts, knowingly. You could. Automatically, you could be charged with a 5th-degree felony if the local prosecutor desired or thought that what that individual had done reached that level. So it's pretty wide open here. It's not that anybody has to do something. It's saying that if the extenuating circumstances are so extreme, that the prosecutor would have that option. That's the basic thrust of the bill. I appreciate your time and the opportunity to present. We'd be happy to address any questions that you may have.
Thank you very much, Representative. It is nice to have you here. And if you notice, your ranking member did arrive just in the nick of time to say this. I do want to ask you, because I know it came up when you were going through this bill, and I just want to know, and I'm trying to insinuate that people talk about the difference in penalties in this case, and then compare them to people who were child providers or had any sentencing for abuse or what have you. And I just heard through the grapevine, that's all it was with the grapevine, there was some concern in that matter. Did that discussion come up in the process in the House? Was it not? I don't remember that part.
The point of discussion as we went through the House the last time was the issue of knowing. That I'm trying to think of the other legal term, and I'm not a lawyer, as you know, Chairman. What the term was that I used, in the opinion of the lawyers in our chamber, some of them felt very strongly about one extent of cold. And he argued that on the floor. Now, this is just too broad, and that is why I went to the Senate on and said, how can they fix this? And it was with the cooperation, really, Senate Coley, and the Representative Oakey, that it came to the language which they felt was broad enough in order to be fair in these circumstances.
Well, obviously, you ended up with large bipartisan support, so I'm sure that's the reason behind it. Question?
Yes, Mr. Chairman, thank you. Been waiting for this opportunity. I represent everybody. Thank you. Now, thank you for your testimony, and thank you for offering this legislation. I have to say, when I served in the House and coming over the Senate, our office was inundated with calls from people across the state, so I certainly want to commend the efforts you've made on this. Can you tell us, just give us a little understanding of the kind of broad-based support you picked up across the state from the people we represent in terms of this legislation, the outpouring of interest and support?
Mr. Chairman, This legislation has supported not only the state of Ohio, and matter of fact, I very, very strong supporters of this legislation to temper their enthusiasm, because I really felt that the message was coming across to members of the House and to members of the Senate. They've done a very effective job of letting these folks know of their interest in this bill. And I find it, seriously, as the ladies last week said, let me just talk to Senator I think that we're moving this thing along, and we've been working with obviously both sides of the aisle on this bill. And but this support is not just in Ohio. I mean, the owners of Nitro, matter of fact, live in New York. That dog was being trained at a training kennel in Youngstown, Ohio. They brought their dog to Youngstown to be trained, and they found out that their 105-pound Rottweiler was 45 pounds. Matter of fact, Mr. Sasko, I talked to him on Friday, and if his wishes of the chairman to have a couple other testimony, he will again travel to Columbus and testify before the hearing.
Thank you for your testimony.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Thank you for bringing this to us. Question, I just want to clarify by way of example. I have a breeder in kennel in my district that is known, pretty notorious, is of having been very, very brutal to the dogs. And ironically, we haven't been able to get charges to stick until he's indicted on rape charges. So that's actually a crime he's in court for now, and not the kennel business. But for the kennel business, I want to make sure that your bill covers this kind of situation. I don't know if there are any witnesses that say he's hurt or brutalized dogs directly, but just lack of care, the dogs fighting each other, dying in the wintertime, no protection, that kind of abuse. Would that sort of abuse qualify as a felony under this legislation?
You, Mr. Chairman, and Senator Schaefer, if you knowingly do not feed the dog problem, then you could be charged with a felony under this law. And obviously that situation is exactly the reason, because it's a licensed kennel. And my personal opinion is that the group should be broader, but obviously, you take what you can get in this process, as we all learn. And this is maybe the first step, because the next step would be go a little broader. But to mistreat animals in that way, I think that at least we should give our prosecutors the opportunity to prosecute that higher level.
Mr. Chairman, I just want to make sure that the not direct abuse, but just ignoring the animals, letting them, die needlessly, suffer in weather, I just want to make sure that qualifies as well.
That would be trying to pick out the term. That would be just torture. Now, once again, let's get up there, Mr. Chairman, in such shape. That would be up to the prosecutor, because the prosecutor is going to have to be able to prove that. But if he honestly believed that this was going on, absolutely, he would be charged.
Thank you.
Yes, sir.
Thank you. Senator Mann.
Mr. Chair, thank you for bringing this to our attention. I have a question. I don't know this, maybe I should, maybe it's good that I don't. Give me an example of a 50-degree felon.
Senator Peterson, I don't know if anybody spoke to Senator Peterson yet, but I want to tell you, this also, Bob, is because you're now in the Senate, I believe at this point now, I'm no longer a junior senator, so I really appreciate you being on board. Please proceed.
You've done very well for a junior senator for several months now. I just want to say thank you, Representative Gerber, for your willingness to go. And it's, you know, my first time serving on the Senate committee. I'm glad to see your face. I'm glad to have you join us today. Thank you for bringing this bill forward.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Thank you, Senator Pearson. We wish you well in your big house.
Well, thank you very much. I very much appreciate it. Thank you for your time, and I appreciate you guys go first. That's pretty
exciting. Yeah, I really appreciate it. Mr. Chairman, members of the committee, thank you very much. I look forward to seeing you.
That will conclude the first hearing on House Bill 108. The chair will call sponsorship testimony on Senate Bill 302.